Hi, welcome to Jamaican Cooking 101. Today we're making chicken pumpkin soup. And this is another one pot Jamaican dish which could be had all year round, any day of the week. So let me prep the ingredients. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Welcome back. So I'm outdoors picking a little pepper for the pot. Now it's good that we have a backyard garden, and I suggest that if you don't have one, you could start one. And you don't have to have a lot of space. You can put your fruits or vegetables in a bag or in a container and you can reap from it. Certainly this can save you a dollar or two, and you get so much self-satisfaction from reaping your own produce. Now, you can tell me in the comment section which is better for soup, a green pepper or a yellow pepper, a ripe one. I have prepared my ingredients here and we are just gonna put them together. Remember now, to make a dish quick and easy, you are to pre-prepare your ingredients. I have some chicken here which was seasoned and I've brought them to a boil. So I'm gonna add some Irish potatoes, some carrots, chocho. But let me show you, this is how small I've cut the chicken. I've had chicken breast and a few bone from the back. There are times when you would have done a dish and you have the bones left over. Don't throw them out. They come in handy for soups and stocks. So I've diced pumpkins and I have not taken off the skin. I want that to stay there for roughage, otherwise known as fiber. And I also have cut them in bite-sized pieces. I'm not gonna put all of them in at the same time. I'm putting in this first set so that it will start thickening the soup, and then the second set will be there for the final part of the soup where, you know, you can have something to chew on. All right, so I'm giving that a good stir. I already have salt and pepper in. And now I'm going in with some white yam. Big up to my farmer brethren, Broshy, who provided us with yams. Now, if you don't like white yam, you can put in whatever yam you want. Yellow yam is fine, whatever yam you want. All right, so we're giving that a good stir and cover it, allow that to come to a boil. As part of my pre-prep, I have gone ahead to make the dough and it is there resting. So it is time for the dough. Let's check the pot. Whoa, look at that. It is bubbling. Now it means that the pumpkin has started to disintegrate, but let me help it out a little bit. I'm going to crush some of them. Now each time you stir that pot, what you're doing is bouncing the food particles against each other. You are creating thickness and body to the soup, right? So now let me quickly crush out a few of them. And then we're going to add the dumplings. Can you see that yellow color coming out from now? Just imagine a little later on, this is gonna be a beautiful soup. All right, now you have to prepare the soup in a big enough pot so it doesn't run over, it doesn't boil over, and you have enough space to stir the pot. Now I'm gonna add the balance of the pumpkin. And I have added these at the last part simply because I want to be able to have pieces of pumpkin in the soup at the end. Now I'm going to be adding some dumplings. I've already done the dough, and you know, you can have spinners or you can have big flat round dumplings, or if you are one of those persons with pretty nails, you can cut the dough with a spoon and drop it in the pot. So different people shape dumplings in different ways. Today, I am going to be doing just one round one and the rest shall be spinners. So thanks again to our viewers and subscribers. It's time to put in a little bit of flavoring, a little bit of spice, and you can use your Jamaican cock soup. And this is absolutely optional. You can achieve great flavor, color, taste, everything by using natural herbs and spices. But today I'm gonna add a little bit of cock soup. What I'm doing is dissolving it in some room temperature water. I don't want the noodles in the soup. I know it will give some amount of thickness, but I don't want the noodles in today. So I've dissolved it in a little bit of water, simply because I don't want it clumping up in the soup. I want it to be evenly distributed. So I'm gonna allow the soup to come to a boil again and then add it. So let's wait for it. Oh my goodness, look at that color. It is absolutely beautiful. You see, you don't really need a cock soup, you know, but it give it that little edge. And you know, it's a Jamaican tradition to have the noodle soup in the soup. Yes, man. All right, so I'm making sure not to get the noodles in, the pasta pieces in. You see the dumpling them? Oh my gosh. It is gonna be a beautiful soup, people. We need to now put in our herbs and spices and continue rolling the boat. Now, this one look like ship. Put some butter in. And of course, butter is optional. If you don't have butter, you can add margarine, but it doesn't have to go in. So I'm gonna be adding the thyme, the garlic, scallion, some French thyme, and the hot pepper. And if you're really fancy, you can tie these in a little bag, the bouquet garni, and so that you don't have to pick them out at the end of the cooking process. So you see my yellow pepper dancing in the soup. Oh my word, beautiful. And remember, this came straight from my garden. Give it a good stir and cover. Dinner is gonna be good this evening. So I'm gonna cover and allow it to come to a boil again. For me, every minute I open this pot because I want to see what's happening. Look at that. Oh my word, this is beautiful. Now you can see all the pieces of vegetables. They are still intact. Many of them are still intact. And look at the pepper. I don't want to burst it, you know, because I'm not sure how hot this one is. But you tell me, do you burst the pepper or do you leave it whole? And do you use a green one or a ripe one? You tell me. No, guess what? I forgot the little pimento. So I just crush up a bit and I'm gonna sprinkle it in. You know, pimento give you a nice flavor. I'm gonna give that a good stir. Remember, you can use whatever protein you want, whether it's salt beef or chicken foot, chicken breast, chicken neck, whatever it is. You can go ahead and use that, right? You know, me have to take a little taste, you know, if everything balanced out, and I'm thinking it is. You know my style already. You turn off the flame, allow it to rest before serving. If you're like me, on a Saturday, I want a decent sized bowl, or you might be a little bit dainty and you want it in a smaller bowl. Whichever is your preference, go right ahead. The soup went taste nice, whichever way. Now I want you to try this recipe. Try it and let me know how it worked out. If you're not from the Caribbean and not familiar with our soup making techniques, here's an easy one to follow. Send your videos and your comments to our contact page on our website and we will upload your videos on our channel. So here we have it, the prize winning chicken pumpkin soup. All right, now this is gonna be a tasty soup, but I can tell you, if you have it the day after, it will taste even better. I've tried it before and I'm telling you, it really tastes good. So thank you for watching. Remember to subscribe and like and comment. Happy cooking!